High fives, take selfies. I took a selfie cutting the net the other night. Just have fun. This is great.
It's motherfucking Frank Mello and motherfucking beat.
A mentality of being tough. We have to, in this league, be more dominant on the boards, more dominant defensively guarding people. And so we were trying to just set a standard of, you know, we're not going to be pumped at the end of the day. We got to be tough. And, you know, so the drills we were doing basically, and me getting onto them, because when you walked in, I was chewing them out for being late. They're supposed to be 15 minutes early. Before anything, 30 minutes early, and so, you know, they got here when I got here, and that's not on time, and so, you know, so they had already started off practice wrong, but you know, we wanted to formulate some mental toughness, some physical toughness, and you know, that day I wanted to pull it out of them. You know, you're gonna give me what I wanted that day.
Does that mental toughness start, you know, with the discipline, like you're saying, you know, being there on time, you know, that way you could be on time for a charge or something like that? Does it start there?
It all goes hand in hand, and I think kind of goes in a perspective that I think a lot of people don't understand, especially when they come as students, that I hold them accountable for every little thing. And I don't think they're used to that. A lot of them don't have parents that have hold them accountable, and you know, and thus it might be the reason why they're here, because you know, they weren't held accountable in the classroom and people let them slide by. They weren't held accountable off the floor, and you know, because they were such a great athlete, they let them do things off the floor that no normal person would probably get away with. But you know, I hold them for every little thing, free throws, you know, layups, you know, their jerseys and shorts being a certain way. When you walk into the locker room has to be a certain way. And you know, when we come back from trips, you know, they put shorts and jerseys in certain bins. And so if we can practice that every day, it becomes a habit and becomes a lifestyle. And so that's what we're trying to change is, you know, it's not so much about basketball, but what are you going to do when basketball stops bouncing, you know, and you have to be on your job, you know, and you have to dress a certain way, and you have to be there on time, and you have to be there early, and boss wants a proposal and a report done at a specific time, and there's not going to be any excuses. So we don't accept them here either.
Coach Francois Bedell knows that talent will only take a team but so far. But a disciplined team with talent can accomplish their dreams. every championship team needs the first option offensively. And who better than the 5'11" sophomore forward from Mobile, Alabama, Japonica James.
It has been an experience with Japonica James.
It's bad if you don't finish.
One of the probably biggest heart kids that I've ever coached, cares about people. Everyone sees the exterior, the tattoos, you know. She's boisterous, she's loud. I mean, she commands a room, she demands the attention. But everywhere we go, they love her. Like, she is the favorite of everybody.
James was one of the most sought-after players after 2016, and one of the most decorated players to ever sign with TCC out of high school. Her cousin, DeMarcus Cousins, is a star NBA player for the Los Angeles Lakers, alongside LeBron James.
And the reason I chose to come to TCC was because when I met Coach Q, I felt like I can trust him and I can really depend on him, put my life in his hands and let him guide it towards the right directions.
Stay right there. Stay right there. Your man is gone, Juju.
And that decision has paid off for the former LaFleur High School basketball star. James led her team to a 34-0 record and a Class 6A state championship in 2016.
To the basket. You're going to do that. You're going to do that. So, Mario, when this ball gets over here, the only way that they can go is back that way. Not like you've been giving up all that good. So the only way that she can go is back that way. All right, she can't go this way. So once they get to the wing, we want to force them back. All right, especially since we know they're clearing it out. Okay, make sense? Can't open up your gate too much, all right? Make sure you use some of this body, not hands.
I seen, you know, Coach trying to express, you know, the purposes of rebounding. You know, just you know, talk about, you know, what that means to you, you know, being playing at your position and how important it is for this team.
He get on me a lot for not rebounding, but it's very important. It do come down to the wire.
In 2016, James posted 23 points and 16 rebounds with 4 blocks in the title game and was named the tournament's most valuable player.
My time with her has been, I've learned a lot. Learned a lot about myself, learned a lot about teaching, learned a lot about, you know, really, you know, moving a kid that is strong-willed, but also a kid that is willing to do anything if she gets your trust and know that you love her and will run through a brick wall. And so, you know, my time with her has been, you know, awesome. You know, Mobile, Alabama, if you've ever been to Mobile, Alabama, one thing I learned is it's, you know, it's one of probably a very hard place to grow up, you know, for a lot of people. And I didn't really realize that until I was there.
Just tell me about, you know, about yourself growing up. You said you're from Alabama, right?
Mm-hmm.
So just tell me about, because I don't know nothing about Alabama. So just tell me about a little bit about you growing up in Alabama.
I mean, it was good. I was raised from my grandparents and my mother, but mostly I stayed with my grandparents. And I came from an athlete family. What do you know?
When you started playing basketball?
When I was like 7 years old.
Okay. It was just spur of the moment, you just saw a ball and just started shooting. I mean, what happened?
Nah, I actually played more than one sport. Like, I had played softball. Softball is my favorite sport.
Gotcha.
But like, my father played basketball and it was his idol for me to play. So, you know, I started young, working out, playing with him or whatever. And then when he died, you know, I just took on and ran with it.
I give Tay Tay for the goal group. So those are the two main people that scored on us, 3 and 4.
Okay.
Right?
So, you got 100, right?
So, for the blue group, the last person, which I don't think, but she will. She's very active on the rebounds. You're going to be...
So what are your overall goals for this?
We're actually trying to win the national championship. I feel like we got the chance and everybody on the same page, so, you know.
James' teammate, Nakia Black, was one of the top players in North Carolina before an ACL injury sidelined her for a year. But Black is a player who can play all five positions and can defend with the best of them.
This way, it took an easy shot and made it hard. All you had was catching time. Right? Nobody was guarding you.
Last time I was at your practice, I saw a coach going over a lot of rebounding drills and stuff like that, you know, kind of running offensive sets. Just tell me what was going on in that practice and, you know, what you learned from, you know, those.
I think it put us in a kind of a aggressor mindset because in the game prior to that, we didn't come out as the aggressor and we lost. So I think he was just trying to, you know, change our mindset.
You know, you run a lot of point guard and stuff like that. Okay. What was I guess coach trying to you know, get you guys to understand about, you know, the offensive sets that you guys were running during that practice?
Speed. Maybe not so much speed, but pace, and learning how to have structure, but to play out of it, and not, you know, just so much be a robot, but to also be a basketball player.
Black prepped at Forest Trail Academy, where she was coached by former NBA player Delaney Rudd.
I could see her in a North Carolina jersey or a Duke jersey or something like that.
She does have that skill set and that ability. And like you said, she was committed to go to UNC until she tore a leg. And so, you know, that's another dynamic that I tell people all about. It's a story in itself. You know, I've known Kai for a long time. I recruited her. You know, she played for my best friend in North Carolina, Delaney Rudd, who's a former NBA player for the Utah Jazz, played for Wake Forest, developed a relationship with him when I was at VCU, and we've just become, like, really best friends and close brothers. And so I've had his kids over the years, and, you know, Nakia has become another one of those kids, but great family, you know, just an amazing young lady. You know, you couldn't ask for a better kid, better family. Like I said, dad, you know, bodyguards for Drake. And so she's cultured. She understands the process. She understands what being great is. She takes challenges. She takes coaching. You know, she's never been an issue. You know, one of your hardest workers gonna fight for you. You know, just in that game, and just, you know, she got so emotional in that game that we weren't gonna lose. She started tearing up, and you know, and it was like a rally cry. And she's that type, that a lot of emotion, you know. And so she's built, brought something special. She was out last year for us, but this year is her first year playing, and you know, she's brought something special, emotion and energy to us that, you know, we need. You know, so she's been a great addition to what we're doing and how we're building it this year.
But you just said you just go in and stop and then turn, work the denial. Just come back out, boom. Hey, I'll turn back around, go get her up, get in here. She dropped my half step in here, and I'm gonna drop right now, boom, we have Ayana on the layup.
Black finished second in her class academically, while freshman guard Julian Redmond received merit recognition for the fall 2017 semester.
When I think about Chicago, I think rough.
Yeah.
You know, so I've never been there, but, you know, just tell me something about her.
So my time in Chicago, you know, I used to coach at Southeastern Illinois, and we would go up to Chicago a lot to recruit. And, you know, there's just a, you know, amazing talent in that area. It's an area that is tapped. A lot of people go there. I mean, you know, my first experience with Chicago was Hoop Dreams, you know. But now, you know, I get to kind of go into the setting and, you know, the environment is rough. You know, and you'll later on throughout the season, you'll get to meet Jamira, who, you know, when you walk into the school, it's literally, you know, cops everywhere. You know, you're getting frisked, getting searched down. You know, as I was recruiting, I spent 7 days in Chicago recruiting Jamira and Juju, and, you know, there was probably about 9 murders within, you know, the area that I'm recruiting them both from Kennedy King, which one of our former employees, Equan, you know, best friend and a colleague, works at Kennedy King, so I'm there visiting him, and, you know, they got the school on lockdown because shooters running through. You see the helicopters, you know. He's like, just stay in the car because the shooter's running, you know, and he's like, I'll let you know when you come in the building. But, you know, they're right down the road from that environment. They're right in that environment every day. You know, but you talk about two resilient young ladies, have a vision, have a goal, have a mindset in what they want to accomplish. That's one thing I love about them. That's one thing that drew me to them. When I spent my time with them, it was just an amazing experience. And not just good basketball players, good people.
So those are the 3 assignments you have. Okay? Everyone else should beat you, but those 3, you're keying on. 9-9 for rebounds. Tay-Tay, because she's active.
Just tell me something about you growing up in Chicago.
Well, it's the area I'm from is the North Lawndale area, the west side of Chicago. Like 20 minutes out from downtown, from the Bean. You heard of the Bean before?
I heard that.
So it's hard. It was rough growing up as a kid, but it's also, it's harder trying to do all the right things. It's easier for you to mess up and go on the wrong path. So you gotta like keep your head on straight to like stay focused and make it to where you want to make it to.
Redmond graduated from John Marshall High School in Chicago. It was named to the 2016-2017 Associated Press Girls Basketball All-State Team 3A Honorable Mention.
Chicago to Tallahassee is a long way. What made you want to come to TCC, this legendary school? What made you want to come to TCC to play basketball?
I wanted to get away.
Okay.
Yeah, I wanted to get far enough away where it wasn't like, if I have a problem, I can go back home. So I didn't want to be able to just have easy access back home, like to run for no reason. Like every weekend go home, but there's nothing there. So.
Stella, did you hear?
Yes.
Hey, Ayan, you heard?
Yes.
I didn't know she said anything. Did y'all hear?
One of the top teams in the country, Gulf Coast, and, you know, one of the keys is going to be us walking in, you know, believing that we can win. And we're just as talented, we're just as skilled, you know, we're just as prepared as they are. But, you know, she's done a good job of making those kids believe that they're going to win. And so that's the one thing we've been talking about, you know, expectancy, you know, walking into games knowing that you're going to win. You're talented, you're gifted, you have all the pieces, they have all the attributes as they do.
What you call 3?
Yeah.
I heard 3, but I ain't know who called it.
I had a clue what we getting into. Alright, my bad. Come on, I hear you.
In 2 days, the Lady Eagles host Gulf Coast State College. A game that Coach Bedell believes the team should come in with a lot of confidence.
Us believing that we're going to walk into that game believing we're going to win. But rebounding, communication, making layups, making free throws. I mean, all the little things are going to matter against Gulf Coast.
Right?
don't stop. Pack. Now, protect the job. Don't be a shooter.
Freshman guard Victoria Pierce was named the leading female scorer in Bayshore High School history, as she averaged about 27 points per game in her senior year.
I saw you was able to get into the lane a couple times, you know, and finish a couple times. What was Coach trying to get you to do out there? Was he telling you to penetrate, or what was he telling you?
I just need to be more aggressive, so. And the girl was playing a certain way, and I knew I could beat her, so I just. Coach Didi told me to be more aggressive, and that's just what I did.
I know Coach was expressing about free throws in the press conference after the game. What is it that you could do in practice to kind of lift up the morale or do extra to kind of get the percentages up?
I feel like we just have to constantly practice free throws. Like, we should make free throws. So I feel like if we would have made all of our free throws tonight, we would have won the game. So free throws is a major part of the game, and we just need to keep practicing free throws.
This TCC women's basketball team isn't far from their potential, but Coach Bedell believes in readiness.
To me, at the end of the day, heart and focus and engagement, and you've got to take your game to another level. And you know, we didn't do that tonight, and that's what it basically boils down to. It's nothing that, you know, we can do more. Preparation and preparing you. It comes down to, are you ready to be in the big moment? And when it hits, are you prepared for it? But it boils down to, sometimes to me, the lack of individual work going into it, because, you know, sometimes when you don't take advantage of the big moment, you aren't prepared for it.
You know, I was talking to Coach, you know, he was saying a lot about rebounding and stuff like that going into the last game. How do you think you guys improved on your rebounding?
Well, we did out-rebound. Like, we out-rebound most of the teams that we play, so that's something we big on at TCC, and we try to keep it up.
We basically worked as the Bigs worked as a team to box out, and we had a focus that we had to get a lot of rebounds in order to win the game. But we also had in our mindset that we want to out-rebound each other, so we just made it a competition.
We're going to focus on just basically guarding the shooters. We're going to focus on guarding the big that's pretty good. She's skilled. And our defensive presence, and then, like I said, free throws and layups. Well, we've been this week with contact, layups, with contact, and, you know, putting them in the hardest situations with pressure to make free throws.
Deny them. If they throw it over the top, we have a person there to get a steal or take a charge. But you gotta be engaged in that. I got you down there just letting people catch it. right? If I dribble at somebody, I gotta cut hard. We move, we pass, boom, we cut. People are open. Once we get people moving and out, then we can get what we want. We can get drives and attack people all day. But y'all trying to go one-on-one, they got defense sitting here. They got defense sitting in their help. They got defense just sitting right there because we haven't moved, we haven't moved, we haven't done anything. And people are just sitting there. I got to dribble that, boom, act like I want it. Cut front her, boom, sprint up. Come here, right? Sprint over. I might cut, backdoor cut. Can't throw bad passes, post players. You got to understand it. We got to know where shooters are. When they're pressured, they haven't been successful, but we're allowing people to feel comfortable because we go under when we should be fighting over, or when we're up too high, we're fighting over when we should be going under. And we cannot allow them to go downhill. And then when we help, we got to close out to the shooters because all they're doing is driving and kicking to wide open people. And our closeout is too slow, too methodical, not aggressive, not hands up. Then when we get them to take a bad shot, we cannot turn and watch. They're going after the boards. You got to turn and find, because we get a person to take a bad shot, and then 32 runs by Tori and gets a tip in. Now, when they do that post-to-post screen, just switch it and deny. Jada, you've done a great job. Again, three quarters. Deny it. Keep the ball out. You know why you two can't do it? Because you too lazy playing behind them. Y'all like this behind them. How many fouls you got? No. You got two. Both of y'all got two. Because you won't do what we're asking you to do.
Half a round.
That's it. When we go 55 red, we're going to have to go 55 red. We're going to have to go quick. People going to have to rotate quick. They got their bigs taking it out. You should have a field day getting steals. I mean, and as simple as that, and that's as simple as plain as I can say it. Because there's no reason why she's not quicker than either one of you. Y'all probably about the same quickness, but they don't match up with your quickness. Like, it should be no-brainer.
For the first 2 minutes, she throw it
in. After Coach Bedell's halftime speech, the ladies warm up for the second half. Their focus should be on liveliness.
Energy, focus, a renewed sense of engagement on what is important, and come to work hard and get better. Still got a long season.
Freshman forward Jada Perry graduated from Wildwood High School in 2017 and led all players in the FHSAA Class 1A Girls State Basketball Final game with 25 points, 6 rebounds, and 5 steals to claim the state title.
Learning everybody right now, but is that part of your game, you know, where you can step out, you know, and hit those type of shots?
Yeah, I mean, I like to play in and out, so really, when I could hit the big shots, it's pretty big for the team. It's extra. So.
What were you trying to get, you know, to your team? I know you were trying to stress to them, you know, to get into their shirts and stuff like that. But what were you trying to stress to them as a whole?
Basically, you know, fight. You know, fight. This is what you play for. This is why you came here to be in these situations, to be top 10 game and, you know, in these situations where everything's on the line. You're playing for a state championship. You're playing for a national title. Tournament berth, you're playing for a conference championship.
You think that has a negative effect on the team when they see the free throws coming out, you know what I mean? And you know,
it's a momentum killer, momentum boost for the other team. I mean, I think they were like 18 to 26.
I have to be more aggressive and be smart and control my team and the game. So I'm still learning how to control the game, so I have to be smart.
You just got finished, but it's a momentum killer for you when you miss those free throws. It kills the momentum.
You know, last week, you know, a disappointing loss because of the free throws. What were some of the things that you guys corrected going into this next game?
Focus as far as making free throws. Just going up there, not trying to miss and worry about what the coach is going to say.
How do you kind of get the morale, you know, for your teammates to kind of make free throws in a game like this, whether it's a top 10 game?
I just think we have to be focused and practice a lot.
I did see you were able to get into the hole a lot, you know, and penetrate and get the shots at the basket. Is that something that coach is trying to get you to do more?
Yes, like attack the basket and create easy shot for my teammates.
Mm-hmm. Last year, they know like that's all I want to do is shoot. Like, they know that's what I do. So I just try to switch it up and get to the rim more instead of settling for a three-point shot.
You think it just takes a little bit more practice?
Yeah.
Okay.
Tonight, basically, it boiled down to us being focused in what we were trying to do. We beat them in every category, but the free throws, we were 15 of 30, and we lose by 5. And so, something that we had talked about, worked on all week, and said it would come down to that. Like, basically, like, rebounding, we won. Free throws is very important, and so it's really frustrating to lose a game in such a simple area when you focused on that, you gear for that, especially in this type of game with so much riding on the line. It's really hard to swallow and take.
Jabonica James finished the game with 27 points and 9 rebounds. Although that effort will result in another loss for TCC.
After a loss like this, what is the most biggest thing that you're taking out of a game like this?
Well, out of the loss, I just feel like going into the next game, we really have to win this game so we can go to state.
tell me about what you guys you know kind of do in the training room and stuff like that.
Besides treatment, we laugh and joke, play around, dance, sing. It's a lot of stuff we do in there.
And what has Coach been telling you guys, you know, in preparation for this next game?
Basically, he told us that we got to focus on our free throws, we got to execute, we got to play fast. We can't play at the team rate, because that's what we usually do, we play down to teams.
What do you think you guys have improved on as far as the rebounding?
I think that our rebounding has improved significantly, because if you look at the numbers, we are out-rebounding teams by a margin of 10 to 15. And that really does help us, because then they aren't getting second chance shots, and it gives us an opportunity to get boards on the offensive side to help us get extra points when we don't make a shot.
You got a wide open layup. Now, it would have been good if you came in here and they commit, well, they commit, and you get a ball right here, and then jump off. That would probably been a better play, because now all Jada has to do is catch it and just go up. Right?
We play semi-good defense. Me. You know what I'm saying? We actually talk to each other. We can play some good defense.
Right down here.
Don't you see what's happening?
Scoring leaders was dismissed from the team due to team rules. This was a huge blow to a team in the hunt for a championship. Jazz Hill led the team in scoring before departure and averaged more than 20 points per game and shot over 35% from beyond the arc. Now the hopes to bring the first women's basketball title to Tallahassee rest on the shoulders of players like sharpshooter Nakia Black and freshman guard Julian Redmond to help carry the load offensively for the rest of the year.
Yeah.
Lady Eagles are coming off of a 5-point loss to Gulf Coast State College and look to right the ship against Northwest Florida State College.
Refresh the services of Pepsi, located at 3919 West Pensacola Street, is the official sophomore partner for Tallahassee Community College. The Courtyard by Marriott, Tallahassee Capital, is the host hotel for Tallahassee Community College Athletics. While there, enjoy a beautifully landscaped.
They are down by 12 in the first half, and we need to put more effort on defense in order to get a victory.
Come on. Tallahassee Basket, number 25, Micaiah Black, number 3.
Thanks to Julian Redman, the Lady Eagles trimmed their deficit to 4 points before the half.
Shot fake and just attack them under control.
Exactly.
We can get whatever we want. If Ponte would just slow down, post players, if you just slow down, bang, bang, fake this way and then go opposite left hand because nobody will go left, but the left is wide open because they sit in everything on the right hand side. If I bang, bang, they're helping, I just kick out to the shooters. Jazz has got to shoot the basketball instead of driving.
And they'll step in wide open, and y'all ain't seen them yet. Like, y'all have to be the most smart, dumbest people I've ever seen in my life. Right? Y'all the same ones that keep talking back to us like, we don't know what we're doing. But when you actually did it your way, it was 20-6. When you started doing it our way, it's 29-33. They scored 3 points. So you tell me, I think we're a little bit smarter than you. So just do what we're asking you to do. That's it. Just do what we're asking you to do. This is a defensive game. It's a possession game. It's gonna boil down to the defense. Attack them on offense. Please understand, everything we do, they know we can only go right. So everything is on the right-hand side of the floor. You gotta spin, fake and spin, and go left. You gotta take them left. Under control, post players, and not run into it. We told you that ain't how it's gonna work. And you know why we can't do it? Because you know what? Kai, Juju, Mari, Jazz, and Tori, and Ayana, y'all so slow in practice that, to be honest, we can't guard no other fast guards because y'all don't show us that. So when a person comes off a ball screen like they're supposed to, we don't know what that looks like, and our posts are all like, because y'all don't give it to us in practice like that. Mm-hmm. We finally woke up, and it was the defensive end of the side of the ball that kept you at bay.
Yeah, yeah.
The defensive end.
What have we worked on all week, y'all? Think about it.
Defense. Now, offensively, you have to be patient, move the basketball. If the basketball reverses, I got to see where the defense is at, and I got to attack the defense. We got to get paint touches.
Well, the guards can't get past nobody.
And like, at the end of the day, all we're saying is we're challenging you. Now, you can take it personal, or you can take it as a challenge. I'm finna show Coach what I can do. You know, I don't know. Like, I got to find some button because what y'all just did was embarrassing. You came back, but the game ain't over with. Like, he's giving them the same talk I'm giving you for coming back. And you know what? The way they start the game, if they come out and start the half and the way you started, if you come out and start the half the way you started, I don't know what's going to happen. It ain't going to be in our favor because it wasn't, I mean, it's 33-29. It's still not in our favor.
18-4. What do you think about it? We got to get a rebound. If we make it, we making a miss and everybody running to the basket, a missed shot is not going to fall right under the basket.
You don't. Number one shot it. You're from here to her, and you turned and ran up under the goal, and the ball came right back to her. When did we teach you that? When did we teach you that? Huh? I mean English. Huh?
Why are you doing that?
Do you see where we stand? Like, we, like, it looks like we teach, like, we don't teach y'all nothing.
This is a disgrace. This how I know y'all don't play hard. Y'all don't really give a. They got 18 rebounds. We got 4. Mm. This is effort. Y'all don't play hard. We got lazy. They should not have 18 rebounds. We got 4 rebounds. One player got more than our whole team.
That's ridiculous. We rotate 10 people. They rotate
7 people. We got 10 people we playing. They got 2 people with the same amount of rebounds. Jay got 4 rebounds. And number 2, the point guard has 5 rebounds.
Look, this is what I say. People, this is what they do. This is not what y'all do. And so I'm being real. Like, I got to replace some of y'all. I'm not going to find people that do this. Y'all play at it.
18-4. Rebounding is effort. Rebounding is will. Rebounding is want to. Rebounding is I'm not finna be lazy. Rebounding, I'm finna sacrifice myself. If I'm tired, I'm still finna go hustle for this rebound. We don't have you. Y'all don't sacrifice yourselves for the team. No, but we've taken about 2 charges in 21 games. We played 21 games.
We've only taken 2 charges.
And we can't even get y'all to sacrifice y'all body for the sake of the team to win the game. We can't get you to beat them to the spot. This is all to win the game.
I will be here next year with a whole new group in the same spot, but in a better position because I'm going to have better players. But understand, and I keep telling you, this is life. And some of you about to figure out what real life is when you're doing this, trying to figure out where you're going to go next year. So you better prove something.
Let's go. Let's
come on, y'all. Go.
We got less than 2 minutes. We got less than 2 minutes.
Y'all, let's go. Shoot it. Come on.
Let's go, y'all.
Come on, let's go.
College Athletics. And what you do is in their ranch at 503 Alpharetta Drive. To be located for all.
The Lady Eagles warm up to begin the third quarter.
Every day.
Yeah.
Checking in for Tallahassee, number 20, Jamonica James.
Lady Eagles will lose back-to-back games for the first and last time of the year. The Lady Eagles host Pensacola State College for an elimination game. A win keeps the Lady Eagles title hopes alive, and a loss equals an end to an historical run.
Shoot a couple threes out there, you know. How is your confidence going into this next game?
Very high. That's bad to say. very high. I try not to think when I play. I try to just let the game come to me. So I don't think it's more so even confidence. I think it's just rhythm.
Time out by Tom Hessen.
Amari Hill injures her ankle on the last possession and forces Coach Bedell to adjust his lineup.
Correction, full timeout. Full timeout, Tallahassee.
These are a few wins that you guys have got a little streak going on. What do you think the biggest contributing factor to that?
Hunger. I think even when we messed up, we still wanted it more. And I think that's why we played with so much passion.
To this game, you know, just tell me how big this game was y'all for y'all to get a win here.
Oh, this was epic. It was literally do or die. You know, you win and you advance. Like Coach said, it's win in advance at this point. So we didn't win, we weren't advancing, and we wanted it.
Charge and you're standing there straight up and she runs by you and you foul. That ain't your job. Your job is to be there anticipating, to stop off, to get boom. And when we don't talk, all right, imagine, and Kai, you were guarding nobody.
The first play of the game.
They shifted, you guarding nobody, and then it throws everyone else off. It threw everyone else off for a wide open layup. And being aggressive and going to go use your body and your strength and win there and get a rebound and go put that back up. Right? You got fouled like on that one drive and they ain't call it. But it's in the flow. But you got us up. Right? Chin the ball. Slow down. It's time to score a possession. Don't just take off, slow down, grab the ball, and a guard come back and go get the basketball. And it can't be all slow. It has to be over there and aggressive like you want the basketball. Can we use a ball screen and go downhill every time you reject it, something stupid happens? Right? You don't know what's going on offensively. We give you a good pass and then you miss it. That's not focus. The layup. So 2 point easy points and 2 points right here and 2 points right there. There's six. And then you just throw that off the glass. Where are you at today? Make a great steal. So these officials, ladies, understand this is going to be three times worse at the national tournament. So what we're getting right now, this is what we'll see at the national tournament, because the officials are horrible there. So how do you play through that? That means I've got to do all the little things. I've got to hit hard when I'm supposed to hit hard. I've got to be up and help when I'm supposed to be up and help. Right? I've got to have my hands out on the shooters because they'll jack that long three. I got to turn and box. Huh?
Got to wall up in the paint.
Got to wall up in the paint. Somebody take a charge. They're going right in there out of control. If you just anticipate, step over and get run over, it takes all that out. Momentum, all that out. But, you know, that takes a little bit of hurt. Takes a little bit of sacrifice.
Perimeter players, you got to stop opening up your gate when they attack the paint. You got to stop opening up your gate just like this and trailing them in. You got to take a step back and stay in front of them. Mar, you got to do it. Don, you got to do it. Juju, you got to do it. Y'all, as soon as they move, y'all open up and you trail them. You cannot do that. Especially if we're in Magic, if we're in Magic Blue. You stay with them. You get around them. You got to stay in front of them. But more importantly, keep them in front of you.
So, 2 turnovers in 4 minutes. So you got to make decisions. Shut the fuck up or back up what you all down there hollering and all that stuff. You got to make a decision. You can't give us 4 minutes and you were the biggest thing on the floor.
Offensively, what play do y'all know that we can execute? Not one?
They're not letting us get into our plays because of the fact that they're hitting our perimeter players so hard. First couple of times down the court, they hit Juju hard off them screens. And then Juju just fumbled.
Because the first thing they want to do, in order to be a good offensive player, the first thing you have to do is look for yours first.
Yes.
You have to look to get to the basket before anything. They know all we want to do is pass to the wing. Tori, you pass to Diana when you should have cross jab, 5 out, make something happen first for your teammates.
And that is basically, boom, what we work on. A stick, boom, go here, they help, it's a dunk,
they
we
not
get
that
an easy
good
layup.
They're not that good.
We make them that good because can't none of y'all handle. This is why I spent so much time on ball handling and moves, and you get into the basket.
And they're reaching in because you're not protecting the ball. The ref's not going to call it. They're reaching in. You got to protect that ball. You have to. You're going to drive or you're going to go for that. You're going to go to hit that screen. You still got to protect the ball.
Put the ball up high. Boom. Pick it up. Go finish.
When are y'all going to hit somebody besides fouling? Hit somebody not while they driving, but while they hitting you, while they getting all these offensive rebounds. We ain't gonna put a body on somebody.
We gotta be tough.
Like the next 20 minutes about who's gonna be tough.
Toughest.
Communication sucks out there. Y'all talk a lot, but when it comes game time, y'all stop talking. Communicate, post player. Hell, I got it. Tori, you told me it was 13. That's fine. I'm out here. You stay up top. It's just that simple. Y'all go mute during the game with each other as far as communication. Y'all talk.
You too worried about what y'all doing later tonight. That's what y'all worried about. I don't know. That's what it looks like. Yes. Now don't shake your head at me. That's what it looks like. That's what you're playing like. Like you're worried about what I'm doing later tonight.
Take care of business now, and let later take care of itself. But take care of business now. Shut these down.
Point blank. And I don't give a if that's on camera.
Come on, boy.
Let's go, Michael.
Chaos on 3, 1, 2, 3.
Chaos.
To this next game, what do you think the biggest things you guys have to work on going into a seeing another four like this?
Communicating on defense, not fouling so much, me personally, but
what's the biggest things you guys want to work on, you know, going into another time when y'all see these folks again?
Having everybody focused and everybody on the same page and everybody on the same day.
Talking about your big shot. Just tell me what was going through your head, take me through that play and what you saw.
I missed 2 free throws before that.
So I was kind of like shaky at the free throw line. So after we got it down, they set it up. I'm like, we got to do something. So I know they was trapping. So I flashed. I just wanted the ball to make a shot to win the game.
Julian Redmond's clutch 15-foot pull-up jumper before the buzzer gave TCC a much-needed win over Pensacola State College.
When it left her hands, it looked good. She was in rhythm, and that was the biggest part of it. And it went in. And it's I keep trying to tell them, it's March, and it's March Madness. And so anything can happen. You got to stay focused. You got to stay engaged. You know, Penny's done a great job over there, and they play their hearts out. And you know, we found a way to win. They probably should have won the game, but we found a way to win, and so that's what March is about.
And when you see your upperclassmen like, you know, Japonica, you know, dapping you up, saying, you know, good job and stuff like that, what does that do for your confidence?
It's just nothing. It's just filling the shoes that she about to leave and then having to contribute more than what she did. She a post player, but a guard, so.
See, you know, dapping up Juju in there. Just tell me about what that was all about.
Man, that's just all excitement to let her know that she won. She ain't crumpled and she ready for the moment. And just letting her know, like, she ain't a freshman no more. She a sophomore. And she might step up and lead her team next year.
You guys were able to put a few wins together. Just tell me what has been contributing factor to those wins.
The wins have been contributing to, like, the off the rebound and making layups get to the paint.
That's what this time of season's about, and it's about win, survive, and advance. And so we survive, and so we get to play one more game. And I told them we're not guaranteed anything after that. But if you take care of business, you're guaranteed, you know, whatever's behind it. So I'm just proud that we found a way to win. We found a way to dig in and be tough when we needed to. And, you know, I'm glad Juju got to make up that, because at the end of the day, those kind of haunt you, and so now it won't haunt her. She gets to make that up, and you know, with that win, it was great. It's fun, so I'm proud of them.
And after the game, the sophomores on the squad are recognized for their time at TCC.
Indiana Tech University, 22 games as an Eagle, she has averaged 4 points, 3.4 rebounds, and 1 assist, doing that in 12.5 minutes per game.
What do you think is the biggest contributing factor to the few wins?
Japonica, congratulations.
Our intensity, our focus, I don't think we showed it for 40 minutes tonight, but that's been the energy, been the biggest contributor. And, you know, them digging and finding a way. In every game, we found a way. And so that I think that's been the biggest thing.
Ladies, on behalf of head coach Francois Bedell, his assistants, and TCC Athletics, thank you for your time and effort as student athletes at Tallahassee Community College. And in case you missed it amongst all the excitement at the end of the game, let me tell you this real fast. The win tonight moved Tallahassee into a tie with Northwest Florida State for second place.
Eagles gear up and get set to travel to Marianna to face Northwest Florida State College. This is a game where if TCC doesn't win, their season is over.
Moving on, it's called March Madness, and we in that moment.
have that opportunity tonight to stand in that moment at March Madness?
It is one of those where, again, I couldn't get happy if I'll be a boy. But it doesn't even boil down to this tonight. Right? Doesn't even boil down to this tonight. It boils down to every effort. Is it going to be a 1-point effort or is it going to be a 4.5 effort? Are you going to be an AP student, basketball player, or are you going to be that resource?
I don't know.
Yeah, I know what the team building is like. You do too, buddy. So we've both been out there. Are we going to be that student? Are we going to be that advanced, go get you, close this down tonight? Shut this down tonight and go take this off. I want you to come out and be a silent assassin tonight. Now, at the end of the day, some of us have to redeem ourselves and we got another opportunity to. Right? Get another opportunity to play the game you love. And when this game is over with, ain't no jumping up and down. We're gonna shake hands like we already knew what was to come. We know what's going to happen tonight. Again, the last time we were in here, we said this gym, this very moment, will come down to this. And we will be here. Right? And we won down as much as 15. And we came back to win. And we showed more heart in that game than any team that I've coached in this gym. A steady beat. That's it. It's a steady beat. And if you stay on pace and you stay steady, I promise you, just like Pensacola, we will come out victorious. We will come out the victor. We will come out. If you just stay at this steady beat, steady pace, and every moment that you're on the floor, you give everything you got.
Mari Hill is forced to watch her team from the sidelines due to an injury.
I let the emotions come to me. I don't try to go into the game with too emotional.
Shoot, I ain't gonna play no defense, I ain't finna switch, I ain't finna do nothing. You killing us. As many points as you got, you've given up double that. So it don't even matter how many points you got.
No, it don't.
Because you've given up more than that. Don, you like a third grade basketball player. Clumsy, falling over your own feet. If you know the ball is flat, why continue to dribble it at 100 miles per hour? Why not take your time if you know the ball is flat?
And time and score, because we talked about time and score situations.
Juju, since you didn't grab that ball, they scored 10 points.
Yes.
28-19. Now it's 30-29.
It's 30-29. 28-19. Have y'all forgotten how to run Magic Fool? When we ran it right, they could not do anything. But you know what? I got people not looking at me. It shows that you not engaged. Well, what the f*** is wrong with you?
Stella and Jamira, y'all just taking up space.
Just space.
Y'all might as well put a boot on with Mari. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, it's sad. And as bad as we play, we up one. That's the sad part about it. You could have just knocked the
game
out the park. The game would have been over with. But y'all want to make stuff hard. You want to be lazy as fuck. You don't want to switch. You don't want to guard. I mean, ladies, there's nothing. I mean, the only thing positive come out of that is that we're up one as bad as we play. But that's a false sense of hope, too. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, we're not doing what it takes to win a basketball game. They're outworking us. They're out hustling us. You shaking like just scared.
She is.
Like, she's scared. All you have to do, you made the move. All you have to do is just raise up, elevate it, and knock the shot down. You doing all this.
She's shooting jump shot floaters. So she's shooting it with two hands like it's a floater. Who taught you that?
Essence? I call Miss Kim and ask Miss Kim to
you shoot jump shot floaters.
After Coach Bedell's halftime speech, the Lady Eagles warm up for the third quarter. Mari Hill's absence was evident as multiple guards tried to compensate for her basketball IQ.
How big was those threes? You know, they came timely. Every time she seen a hit one, it seemed like it was right on time.
Oh, Nakia came huge tonight with her three-point shooting, and just proud of her. Stepped up and the big-time guard that we think she is, and made it work tonight. So, just, you know, we got to get back in the lab and get better.
Nakia Black focuses on putting the ball over the front of the rim, where she shoots nearly 80% from the charity stripe.
Earlier, you were saying that you know, how the tempo that Mari brings, but you actually got to see that live in person.
Yes, we miss her. Tonight, due to the fact of she creates so much stability and controls the game when we need to change the tempo and time and score, and so she was really missed. And defensively, she was missed because of just her IQ on the defensive end. So, but we found a way. Like I said, we found a way to survive and know that we can win without her.
Mari, it seems like, you know, before the game, I always thought she brought this little calmness,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
to set up the sets, you know, type of guard. What does she bring to this next game going into Ocala?
We always get on Mari about always trying to set up the offense and not going to down here going to score. But today we needed somebody to kind of set up the offense, you know what I'm saying, and not try to force stuff so much, you know, especially towards the end with this time situation score. Like, we got a couple turnovers, we couldn't get the ball in a couple times. You know? It, either she going to throw it in, might turn it over, but at least we're going to get it in. You know what I'm saying? We're going to get an opportunity to get the ball. So, yeah, we miss Mari today. We got to get it back.
Defense!
Aponica James is shooting a little over 60% from the free throw line, but hit one of two from the line to extend the lead with just under a minute left. Without a field goal and managed just 3 points the rest of the game. After Nakia attempted this shot, she hobbled off the court with a leg cramp.
Shoot it.
How excited are you about to go on Cali?
Oh, I'm excited. School history, back to back. They've never done that before, and you know we get a chance to play another day. Wasn't pretty, but we take it.
Yeah!
Contributing like that, you know, with those big threes, they seem like it was real time. How big were they this year?
Huge, man, huge.
Kai is defensively and offensively like one of the best players on our team. You know what I'm saying? But when she's locking down shots, it makes her want to play defense. You know what I'm saying? So if I, as the more we see go in, you know, the better she's gonna be on the defensive end. You know that we know. That's a good picture, y'all. That's some good pictures.
This is shady.
I didn't even know.
It was a big game. I feel like we didn't play as our best, but we played to get a win. We fought through adversity. At the end, it could have been better. It wasn't pretty, but you know we satisfied because we still got the win.
Everybody coming. Here we go. One, two.
At the beginning of the game, I saw you. You know, you was telling her to shoot the ball. You know what I'm saying? And she ended up going 6-for-8. How big of that had a part of?
I feel like all my shooters should shoot. Like I feel like if you got a shot and you got the opportunity, if they don't want to put a hand up, take a shot. Even if their hand is up, take a shot if you got it. I just feel like all my guards should shoot.
The Lady Eagles get set to take on Daytona State College in Ocala, Florida. Maury Hill is out of the boot and is back on the floor dressed to play for this game. Begin this game with supreme confidence after a narrow victory against Northwest Florida State College.
All right.
The Lady Eagles started slow against Daytona State College, but they closed the first quarter on a 13-3 run and led 19-16 after the first 10 minutes. Jada Perry came off the bench and scored 12 points and grabbed 9 boards. Dawn Gibson had 10 points. Ayana also reached double digits as a reserve, scoring 11.
We have an administrative technical foul on the Falcons for having the incorrect player number in the foot.
We
gotta
come out with AK scoring 2 and 3 scoring 9.
One of the things we got to do a better job of is when we're in our half court, our back people. You keep picking a side. You have to split the defenders. If we've got people up there, you're in the middle of the floor, you're splitting the defender, right? So if they start to drive, now you can get close out on one side because it's going to be on one side or the other. You all keep picking a side and it's leaving one person open. Does everybody understand what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. You got to split the difference. We got to make number three play faster than she wants to play. She can't make very good decisions when she's under pressure and she having to speed up, right? So those are the things we gotta do, right? And then you see everything that's going on in the back. And you gotta talk to people. First 5 minutes is gonna be the crucial 5 minutes coming out here. They cannot score in the first 5 minutes of the game. You gotta dominate them. And it starts on getting second opportunities on the offensive end and putbacks, making layups. You notice they're letting you hit. They call a lot of fouls on it, but they're letting you hit. So they're letting them hit you, so you gotta finish regardless. And then, so when I go up, it's got to be, I pump fake, they jump, and I go up and I go through the contact. I'm patient. And then when we get, when the ball comes out, we've got too many people jogging back. It's a dead sprint back. Because what they're doing is they're throwing the ball back, and that's a steal. Right? Don, you were able to get some stuff done because you were patient. You were patient in the play. Pani, you got to do the same thing. You got to slow down. Just slow down. Right? Forget about all the people you're trying to impress out here and just play basketball like you can. Right? So get out of your own head and get back to being Pawnee. Right? You good? You good? Right? You good? Right? We're in the league without you playing well. So that to me tells me we're good.
Good job, man.
You know, they had your back. Now you're going to get their back. So you good. Right? So don't, you good. We got you. Now, it's your half show who the fuck you are. Come on, Pinky.
You better stop playing.
But that's the word. We got bubbles. Now, it takes us getting on the glass and it takes our defensive effort. Okay? It takes our defensive effort. Now, at the other, on the other end, you know, Juju. We got to attack under control. We got to see people. Like, y'all, we got to see the floor a lot better. Because we got people swinging, and we got people we create, and we got shooters open. We got to hit them. We got to hit those people, right? Got to put arcs on the shot and be ready to shoot the basketball. Right now, please understand, if shot fake get by somebody, if you got the shot, be ready to shoot it. We got to go get a rebound, and we got to get back. We're winning the game. Y'all know that, right?
Yeah.
So on offense, will y'all, and we get a second opportunity, would y'all act like we're winning the game instead of panicking? Y'all taking some bad shots. Right? We want you to be aggressive, but you being aggressive, we got people starting to do Euros at the three-point line. Who does a fucking Euro at the three-point line? Now that was, and now it is, boom, I cross over and I go with my right hand and get to the middle of the floor and I get right here at the bucket. That's all that is. It's not a Euro.
The Lady Eagles get set to begin the second half as they warm up with their layup drill.
Pressure that you guys were applying was able to be so effective?
I think they had one person that kind of runs the ship, and so we were able to kind of disrupt her and speed her up, and I thought it played in our favor. You know, I think they ended up with 20-some-odd turnovers, so it helped us get extra baskets. We started doing, turning them over a little bit more in the second half.
I seen y'all working good together as a team. Why y'all was able to have five people in double figures tonight?
Everybody had said that we're going to, you know what I'm saying, do what we got to do to make sure that we play a state championship game. Like, everybody bought into it.
Everybody played so good tonight. I seen y'all have five people in double figures tonight. What do you think went so well?
We know what we're playing for. We have a different type of chemistry now. Not only are we playing for the championship and rings and everything, but we're playing for each other. So.
Don't say nothing. Just take the game. But they trying to take the
fucking.
Okay,
come on, y'all.
Take the game.
Hey, come on, y'all. Shut up.
Come on.
I saw the defense was able to pick it up a little notch. Why do you think y'all was able to be so effective?
We listen. Sometimes we be hard-headed and we just don't. We hear them, but we be trying to do our own thing. So we listen, and then we did it because we wanted to.
Up. five players in double figures. Why do you think everybody was playing such a great team ball today?
Well, I think because that's what we've been emphasizing. We need everyone to contribute. I don't even think Japonica played her best game, but I think her teammates had her back. And we're going to have multiple people help us win down the line. So it can't just be one or two people.
And going on to this next game, what do you think is important for you guys to practice on?
Rebound, most definitely rebounds. We got to get rebounds. I mean, we got to finish shots because we had a lot of shot attempts, but, you know what I'm saying, our percentage was kind of low.
Against the Gulf Coast, and then Eastern Florida State to take on Tallahassee in the nightcap tomorrow at 8 p.m. We do thank you for your attendance here. Ask you to please drive carefully on the way home.
After beating Daytona State College by more than 25 points, the Eagles face Eastern Florida State College of the NJCAA District FHSAA State Basketball Tournament. Were on fire from beyond the arc, hitting 9 3-pointers, while the Lady Eagles were only able to knock down 4. Julian Redmond led the team in assist, while Japonica James and Nakia Black combined for only 28 points.
So what do you think was the biggest reason why the effort wasn't there tonight compared to the other night?
I'm gonna let you see. I feel like the energy.
Tallahassee scored the first 5 points of the game, but Eastern Florida State College went on a 16-4 run and led 16-9 after the first quarter.
Giving up, turning our hip, giving them too much space. You got to know where people are, shooters. Right? Now, all the offensive end, we're running stuff. You guys are holding the ball, and you're going to attack.
tonight. Y'all tell me y'all can't get past nobody? Y'all can't get past nobody. And that's ready just getting past us. Y'all can't get past me.
The Lady Eagles were thoroughly beaten on both sides of the ball, and they couldn't get any closer than 8 points in the closing minutes of the game.
We got nobody to get by nobody. How bad you want it? We've been in worse positions than this. We were down worse at Chipotle than this. But it's a mentality. I keep telling you about a mentality, March Madness mentality. They have a mentality that they're gonna slay you. You came in here like you just thought they were gonna lay down. Did y'all not watch the first game before? How long it took them to get Florida Southwest off their back? But you know what? Gulf Coast kept getting by people and going to get buckets and make free throws. And we ain't got not one person doing that. I already told you how the official was going to be. So we ain't worried about the officiating. You got to go make easy buckets.
You got to run 1-2-2 magic. When it, you force them, you follow the top person, follow the ball. We can start off a man, see how that works. If it don't work, we have to start trapping them in half.
We go that because it ain't working. Yeah, we go that.
So we going flat and
trapping on. No, we going 1-2-2 like Daytona State Rim when you follow the ball. Our wing, the ball go to the wing coming up, and the top person coming up. Uh-huh. We have to get them to make air passes
and
give us a chance
to get the ball
out. And if we don't get it, it still give us a chance to get our hand up on a 3-point shooter. A direct pass, we're not gonna get there. A zip pass, we're not gonna get there. One of these give us about 2-3 seconds to get there. Do you know what I'm saying? We have to. The game ain't over.
Let's go, y'all.
The other thing is, you're gonna have to defensively read the floor. When the ball is moving, you know they're gonna try to hit shooters. The ball is moving this way. I'm not worried about this right here. Everyone else has to rotate and move.
Right? Y'all standing here, and the person's coming here, so I got two people guarding the post, and then they got wide open three-point shooter. Well, that should be you closing out to the three-point shooter. And you telling me you worried about this man down here. That is not your man. That is your man. And then you all are just settling just for shots. Ain't nobody getting by anybody. Ain't nobody able to get, boom, just get by somebody and go finish.
You think that's something that, you know, could be corrected in the next, you know, couple of days or so? Or?
Definitely. I think we even picked it up in closer to the end of the game, fourth quarter, halftime. But I think that's just something that we came out to be.
And athletically, this didn't seem like it was athletic to y'all or nothing like that. It just seemed like y'all weren't closing out on the shooters.
Yeah.
Was that a part of it?
That was really it. Like, because if you think about it, none of them girls quicker than us, you know, they really couldn't play with us. But they were just making smart plays.
Please know why the effort wasn't the same as it was the night previous.
Focus. You know, mental focus. We're still young. We got a lot of players who haven't been through this, haven't experienced it, and you know, it came back to bite us in the butt. I think tonight. But you know, I'm proud of their second half effort. They didn't quit. I don't think we ever quit. I just think we just didn't take advantage of stuff, missed easy chip shots. But I felt like they kept fighting. So. That's a great thing going down the stretch, especially if we make it to the national tournament. They got something to prove now, so that's kind of how we'll twist it and use it in that regard.
Y'all gotta right? You gotta make the free throws. Can you make these free throws? You gotta have them.
Japonica James suffered a facial injury and was sidelined for the majority of the second half. She received treatment for the injury and played after the injury. Although the Lady Eagles won five straight games before this loss, this will be the last time the Lady Eagles will lose a game en route to the school's first national title.
Didn't do the little things that we needed to do. I feel like we got out hustled. Eastern Florida came out and played their game, hit some threes that kind of got them up. And I thought in the second half we fought back a little bit more, but just didn't have enough in the tank. Missed a lot of easy buckets.
return back to Tallahassee with a championship, something that no other team in TCC history has done. And the support system for the TCC Eagles were all in attendance to watch the Lady Eagles return back from their trip to Texas.
We did it. I knew we were going to do it. I knew we could do it. It sounds a little cocky, but honestly, I have faith in me and my girls.
That's like the best feeling ever, honestly. It's like a dream come true. That's something that every athlete would dream about.
Staying consistent, staying diligent, and it'll pay off.
What was it after that on that Ocala loss that made y'all bring it all together and go on this 5-game winning streak?
Our focus, like we locked in to what everything coach was telling us that we needed to do.
Thank you all. This right here is awesome for you to be out here. I know the girls are really be glad to get off the bus. We've been on that bus all day, but to try to get here. And we just thank you all for your support. We thank you for everything that you have done for us, from the community to faculty, staff, board of trustees, Dr. Murdahl.
I just want to say, as president of the college, how proud I am of you and for you. Coach, you did a remarkable job. And listening to the stories of the grit, good for you. I mean, you went out there with a purpose. It's really clear. We're so proud of you as student athletes and what you've done for our college and for our community. I hope you know how many people in this community are talking about you and are talking about TCC thanks to you. And I just have to tell you how much I appreciate the hard work, the dedication, and even giving up your cell phones. I mean, that was pretty, I know what that must be like. That sacrifice. So again, Coach, thank you so much. I'm glad Rob offered you the job. I'm glad you took it and chose to be here. So thank you for what you're doing and for all of the folks here at TCC. And we are, some of you don't know this, but the chancellor of the college system in Florida was a women's basketball player at Miami-Dade College, and the chancellor wanted to be here today to offer you some remarks. So give it up for the chancellor, Madeline Pereira.
Coach, you said it right. What happened is doesn't happen overnight. It's not 5 days, and it's just not one tournament. It's you bought on to a vision for yourself, for the college, for the state, and you played your hearts out. I watched some of it, I was watching Twitter feeds, and the great news is, I have to tell you, I have to say it because I'm the chancellor, Florida just rocked it. Right. And we were so well represented. But to bring it home, to have Florida teams win back-to-back, and what it means to all of you as student athletes, as amazing women, and to do this on Women's History Month. And as the president said, I started my collegiate career at Miami-Dade Community College, played basketball. Would not be where I am today without sports. Went back and coached for 5 years and then worked my way up, and today I'm chancellor, so I hope you're here. Just a few years from now, being chancellor, saying to the team from TCC, you were the first to bring it home. Welcome home, national champs.
I just really want to thank Rob for giving me this job. This doesn't happen if Rob doesn't hire me. And I thank him for seeing the vision 5 years ago. I thank every player that has come through here that didn't get a chance to experience this. They were in our spirit. They were part of this. But I thank these young ladies. They bought into the process in the classroom. They bought into the process of my toughness, accountability. They've been on curfew all year. You know, they've done all the little things that we asked. And when I say I witnessed something amazing out of them this week, absolutely amazing. You don't do what they just did in 5 days against the defending national championship champions, Gulf Coast, who went down. And then you face a historical team in Trinity Valley who's won 8 national championships, and they took all those people down this weekend to become the national champions. So kudos to these young ladies, and we thank you so very much. And we can get prepared to win another one next year.
Come on, Mr. Lamb.
Just an honor. Just an honor to see a championship. I was a basketball player in high school. I was a basketball player in college. And I had a trial with the Harlem Gold Trials after I finished college. But I tell you, this made me really feel good coming from Tallahassee, bringing the championship back home. It's just an honor to see a championship team here at TCC, the best community college in the state of Florida and the country right now. So I'm just so happy for you guys. And keep it up. Stay in the classroom. Get your lesson. Be professionals. And we look forward to seeing you again next year at the same place. Thank you.
Okay, I think that wraps up any formal remarks. Obviously, the team will be out here. I'm super proud of them. So, Coach, ladies, congratulations.
Last time we talked, you know, you was in Ocala, y'all coming off a loss, but you said there was some things y'all could correct. What was the steps y'all made to correct those things?
We took practice very serious. We took heed to what the coaches were saying, and we took every possession very seriously.
I mean, what was it in the tournament? Wasn't it just a defensive intensity that picked up?
It most definitely was defensive intensity, and the defense kind of brought our confidence with the offense, you know, because every time we got a steal or every time we got a block or something like that, you know, it'll boost up our confidence to go, like, to the basket, go do some, you know, cool-looking shot or anything like that.
Come on, we won. Hey. Okay.
Yo.
The national champs won five straight games to capture their rings. First, they beat Western Nebraska Community College 97-85. Then they beat Wabash Valley College 75-69. Then they faced their arch rival Northwestern Florida State College and beat them 55-52. After that, they beat Gulf Coast State College 78-68. And finally, the Lady Eagles faced Trinity Valley Community College in the championship game, beating them 69-51.
What's your favorite food?
Wings.
Who's your favorite basketball player?
Candace Parker.
Candace Parker, okay. What's your favorite food?
Thank you.